Next, once you completed this, you click this button here. Next, you go for new design option here. New design. Go for new design.
So we can. Yeah. Sir, where is the option new design?
New design at the top. You can able to see, sir.
Left corner, no?
Yeah. So again, next.
That new design, it has been mentioned as 3D design. Like box.
No, sir. Here, if you click this, you get a screen like this, no? So here, top here, one option is there, no? Recent design. You click there.
Where I can click? Can you tell me once again?
In the previous design, okay, here your name is there, no? Char 1 I have put there.
Yes, sir. Char 1.
Begin that, adjacent to that, there will be one icon will be there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You
yes,
just
sir.
Click that.
Okay.
So this screen will pop up. There, new design will be there. You just click
yes,
that.
Sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we'll get the next thing. Next, we can go for that. What I send you, spanner.
The cup.
Kappa, okay, kappa, teacup. So teacup can be done in any design. It may be a cylinder one, or it may be somewhat curved one. Okay, both the design I will tell you. So first you take the cylinder, plug the cylinder, place it here.
Second one is wrench, actually. Okay, anyway, no problem.
Okay, anyway, no issue. Sir, Rashaya, sir, don't worry. This video is recorded. Once we will send this video. How to do this? Don't worry. You can try at your home also.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
So just click this cylinder here. So first thing. So cylinder has a dimension. One is a diameter. Another one is height.
Sir, you are recording the video.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, bro.
Recording. You change the diameter. See, how to change the diameter is if you click one of this white color button is there, no? If you click that, so if you move that, you can change. There are the dimensions are changing in two different ways. Here it is changes to 32, and here it is changes to 25. You can see here, no? So in order to avoid that, press shift button in your system. Pressing shift button, then press this, then you move this. Both the dimension will be uniformly changes. So now the diameter is increased to 40.
Once again, sir, that millimeter, that unit, where you check?
Yes, sir, 1 mm. That will be default unit. Millimeter.
You select, no?
Yes.
Millimeter or centimeter.
Here is there, no? Bottom. Snap grid is there.
Where? It is down, huh?
Down here. I am marking red color box, no? There.
Okay.
If you want to edit that, you can go to click and edit grid. If you there, inches, millimeter, so many options will be there. Whatever you want, you can put it.
Okay.
I am selecting cylinder and placing it over the work plane, and I am changing the dimension. For changing dimension uniformly, you click the shift button and you click this box and you can move so that the dimension will change uniformly. So I am keeping it to some 50. Or you want, you can type manually also 50. So height I am changing to some 60. This is the height. So next I am going to have the handle for this cup. For handle, I am going for torus option here, no? Torus. You just click the torus option in the basic shape. Torus. Just click this. Rotate this. Rotate this. Then you move upwards. Same black color triangle, click that. Just move upwards some distance. Then you move this and place it there. Wherever you want, you can place it there. It's up to you how your design should be there. If you want to increase the width, you can increase the width. And if you want to move down, you can move down this.
So how you are changing to that in a vertical manner?
Changing the angle, sir. You change that angle into 90 degree. I will show you. Initially, it was like this, no? Once you select this, it will come like this. Select the torus button here. Place okay. it here. Okay. So, rotation angle is there, no? Just click that.
Oh.
90 degree. Either you can put manually, or if you want to rotate that, press the shift button in your laptop. Then using the mouse, you can rotate that to the desired angle. Once it was done, you move this at some distance upwards. For moving upward and downward, you have to click this black color triangle, then use your mouse button, then use move upwards or downwards. Once it was done, just move it, place it in the cylinder. So if you want to increase the height, you can increase the height and you can move it downwards. If you want to move out also, you can move. I think now it's fine. Okay. Okay, fine. Any doubts on this?
Can you give the taper surface for the cup, tapering surface?
Tapering surface means this one, sir.
From the upper, it is more. Down, it will be small. You mean bottom will be small, wrong?
That I will upper, show in the next thing. Next thing, I will show you. Shape we have to take okay. differently. I will show you.
So again, how you are getting into that half the shape of that that holder, no? Getting half shape, but when you are...
Just you are moving that, that's all. See here. The option is just move that.
Oh, okay.
See, you just okay, move this.
You will get a cup. Okay.
So it will go inside. Okay. You can see it is going inside. Fine. Okay, now it is a solid cylinder. We have to make it as a hollow. It is a solid cylinder. We have to make it as a hollow. For that, you click this cylinder. Click this cylinder. Make duplicate of that. Okay, click the cylinder. Make duplicate of that. You will get one more cylinder like this. I am now going to make it as a hollow cup. So I am click that, I am making a duplicate of the cylinder, I am taking out. Okay, for your understanding, then I am for your understanding purpose, then I am place it in the same place. You can see here. Place it in the same place. Once it was done, you just click that. You click this black color triangle and move the duplicate cylinder upwards. Okay. So this will give the bottom thickness. You can see a 10 mm. You can change this to 16 mm. So how much bottom thickness you want, you can give. So I am fixing it as a some 10 mm here. Or 9 mm, whatever you want, you can fix it. So the bottom thickness will be 10 mm. Next thing is, I am going to remove this. For that, I have to create a wall thickness for that. So press Shift and Alt. Press Shift and Alt in the laptop button. Then press this white button. Now it is convert changing into red. No, you can able to see. Press Shift and Alt button in your system. Then click this. Then you reduce the dimension. How much wall thickness you want? Initially it was 50. Now I am reducing it to, why I am pressing Shift and Alt is, then only you will get the uniform change in the dimension, both the sides. So if you want to 2 mm wall thickness or 4 mm, 6 mm wall thickness, whatever you want, you can fix. Suppose I am reducing it to 46. So initially it was 50. Outer cylinder is 50. Now I have reduced to 46. Hope everyone has understand how I did this. Fine. Can I move to next step? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Once it was done, you click this. You click the duplicate cylinder. Click that. Then you have two different options here. One is solid and another one is hole. You click that hole button. Click that hole button. Once it was done, then you select the thing, both the things. You group it. You group it. Then you can see hole will be created. This is fine.
Change the color now.
Color, you can have any color, sir. Yes, sir. You can have any color. You just you can click it and you can change whatever color you want. You can change. So you want green, you can change. But in print, you won't get any color. It depends upon the material what we are using.
Okay.
So once it was done, you group everything. Already group. Then you save this. Give name to this. So I am putting it as cup 1. Then convert to STL file. All the design, whatever you are designing in Tinkercad, will be stored in the cloud and you can retrieve it whenever you want.
Okay.
So, then we can go for different shape of the cup. Once it is done, I am moving to next one. Start new design.
So again, I'm having problem with that holder alone. I try to insert in that cup, but fully it is not going.
Here I will show you, sir. Here I will show you. Same teacup I am going to design in another way. So he has no top different shape and bottom different shape. For that, you select this object, paraboloid. One option is there, no? Paraboloid. Select that, place it here. So next design, I am going to do the same teacup. This I am taking it as teacup 2. Cup 2, okay. So if you want to increase the height, you can increase. And if you want to increase the dimension, you for change in uniform dimension, press Shift and you change. So whatever the dimension you want, you can change the dimension. Once it was done. So this is the first thing. Next, I am going to make the bottom of the teacup as a flat one. Okay, so this I am going to make it as a flat one. For that, how to do is click the rectangular box, place it here. You just make a larger rectangle than this, like this. Just enlarge the dimension of the rectangle. I think hope you understand what I am saying. Once it is done, you click the black triangle of this rectangle. So you can move up this rectangle, you can move upward direction. Okay, until that paraboloid get vanished, until that you can move upwards this rectangle.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see here. Okay, so how much bottom surface you want, you can change the dimension accordingly. Hmm. You want cup like this, or if you want cup like this, so it's up to you. The dimension is up to you. Accordingly, you can change. So once it was done, you click this rectangle, then you go for this hole option. Once this hole is clicked, you select these two, group it. You can see the bottom is flat. So this is the bottom of the teacup. Then you rotate this. I am rotating this. Either use shift button and rotate this, or you type it as here 180.
180.
So you get the teacup of different shape here. Top size is different and bottom size is different. Once it is done, then you can go for the handle. Save. Taurus. Click that Taurus. Rotate this.
Can we copy the certain parts from the previous already completed?
Yes, sir. You can import here. Import option is there. No. Import option is there.
Is it possible?
Yes, you can.
Now import. You are creating a torus and fixing. No, directly. If I am having a previous one here nearby.
Yeah, that's why I am saying here. Import. You can see here. Import option is there. Sir, are you there? Am I audible? What I am saying? Am I audible? Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So if you want to import any previous images, so here import option is here. Okay, you can choose any file from there. You can import here and you can take that object from there. So once it is done,
create again and again certain parts.
No need, sir. Every all design is stored in the cloud, in Tinkercad.
We can just pick and
yes.
Add.
Yes.
Okay.
So I have changed this to 90 degree. Okay, so then I am going to move this, move upwards. How much distance you want, you can move upwards. Then you can move this to the cup. You can see it is slowly getting inserted. So how much distance you want, you can get inserted.
Okay. Okay. But exactly it should be 90 degree. Otherwise.
No, sir. It's up to your design, sir. Whatever, how much angle, if you want in your handle, usually the handle of the teacup will be 90 degree. Okay, it will be straight.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's just your creativity, that's all.
Okay.
Hope this is fine. Or if you want to move somewhat inside also, you can move. If you want to change the height also, you can change the height. Okay, once it was done, okay, it is fine. Once it was done, now we are going to make a hollow cup there inside. Okay, so click this, duplicate this. So you will get one more image of this paraboloid there. So just click that black color button. You can move that. You can see one more object coming there. So you can give the bottom thickness. How much bottom thickness of the cup you want, you can give that. So here I am giving it as 9. So it is I am giving it as 10. So your next step is I am going to reduce the shape in order to create the wall thickness. So press shift and alt in your system. Click this white button, it will turn to red. Then you reduce the dimension. Initially it was 37. Now I am going to reduce from 37 to 4 mm. I have reduced to 33. Okay, fine. Once it was done, click this, go for a hole. Once hole was created, select all the things, then you group it. You will get a hollow cup. This is the normal take cup. Fine, no sir. Any doubts in this?
Sir.
Okay, if you want to put any names here, your name or somewhere else, you can put your name also. Mm-hmm. Okay, character option is there. Sorry, text and numbers is there. Suppose I want to put some letters A here. Click that whatever letter you want, click it here. So first,
but, this letter should be of a different color. While printing, we have to give.
While printing, you will get only one color. Purely depend upon the material color what you are using.
Okay.
Same color you
but
will get.
If I write my name, this color, the text color will merge with the total color, right?
No, sir. The color and all you can only see in the design alone. Okay.
If I'm writing my name in the cup, on the cup, I'm writing my name.
Okay, so I will tell you, sir.
Then.
Okay. Yeah, tell me, sir. Tell me.
I'm writing my name, Ram Mohan, over that cup surface.
Okay.
Sir. If I'm writing the text, then when I'm doing 3D printing, what happens? It is going to be as the color of the filler only. Correct.
Color of the polymer only you will get, yes, obviously.
Polymer only we get.
Yes, yes.
But that so in that case, we cannot differentiate the text and the surface of the cup. Am I right? So for that, what?
Yes, for that we have to go for that post-processing. Yesterday I told you, you can paint that text alone once it was printed in FDM.
Oh, it should be a post-process.
Yeah, if you want a color to be printed, then you can go for multi-nozzle printing. For that part alone, it will print in different color. If you go for polymer jet printer is there. There you can select the multiple color option. So handle I can have in one color, and inner surface I can have in one color, outer surface I can have in one color. So it depends upon the printer what we are using.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So I will tell you the name how to put here. So I am putting IIR. Okay, so first you name this, then you group this first so that the width can be changed. Okay, so the next step is you can rotate this. Okay, once you rotate this, you move this towards here. So since it is a curved surface, you can change the width of this letter accordingly, so that it can place over there. You can see it is going inside. So you change the dimension. And you project it somewhat here. Okay, fine, sir. So you can give the thickness here. So the thickness, I will recommend you to give you a thickness for some 4 mm to 5 mm, so that the letters will be printed in the 3D printer. If you go for some 2 mm or 3 mm, then it will be, the letters will not be visible. Okay. So you can see here.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon.